right. Good morning, everyone. Thank you for being here early on a Sunday. My name is Erin Stine, and I'm the Director of Undergraduate Admission here at Parsons, and we're really excited to share with you today our incredibly unique Associates AAS programs. Mr. Towers might be joining us a little bit later today, so I'm just going to kick things off. But the AAS degrees at Parsons are really quite unique in that the population that it serves are those who are typically thinking about advancing or changing careers versus someone who might be just starting a university program at age 18. These degrees have actually existed kind of in the form they are now as professional degree programs for the last 20 years. So students that come to us are coming from all different backgrounds, and I hope today to answer the question that many of our students interested in these programs have, which is this the right program for me? The AAS degrees at Parsons are really meant to take a professional student, a professional person, and transform them in a period of time of 2 years or less. Our students that are going to pursue this program, depending on transfer credits, if you've been to university before, will typically take between 2 and 4 semesters. Later on in this presentation, we'll answer kind of the differences between what's an associate's degree at Parsons versus a bachelor's degree versus a master's degree. And I do also just want to mention, if anyone in the audience is in high school, that the associate's degrees are actually not for someone in high school, but we do have a special session to address those questions that you might have if the bachelor's seems like it might be more appropriate today. Parsons School of Design is one school within the new school. Overall, we're a university of about 10,000 students, with over half of those studying art, design, and business at Parsons. Throughout the university, we find our students really taking advantage of all we have to offer as a larger university. So while our students are studying fashion marketing, fashion design, graphic design, and interior design at Parsons, they're also taking advantage of our, they have two music schools, the School of Jazz and Manus, which is our classical conservatory, as well as the School of Drama. We also have Eugene Lang College, which is our undergraduate liberal arts degrees, and our students studying at the New School for Social Research and the New School for Public Engagement at the master's and PhD levels. And all of those different minds and skills combined really make the new school what it is as a whole. But today, we're going to specifically focus on those AAS degrees at Parsons. So to get more into the meat of things and talk about the programs themselves, the application process, and the many other features of the university, I'd like to introduce my colleague, Phil Braun, who will talk a little bit more in depth. Thank you so much.
Well, welcome. My name is Phil Braun. I'm the Associate Director of Undergraduate Admissions. Thank you, Erin, for your kind introduction. As she mentioned, this program is designed for adult students who are looking for career transition and career enhancement. So it is a unique program in that it's an associate degree for students who come with a professional and educational background. And as she mentioned, we'll have a separate session for students who are directly out of high school or looking for their first degree. So let me tell you a little bit about our AAS degree programs and a little bit about the school itself. The Parsons School of Design has been a leader in design education since its founding in 1896, and it's a unique world-renowned art and design school housed within a comprehensive university, the New School. Parsons has a diverse community of students that develop critical thinking skills and apply them to real-world challenges to solve the design need solutions that we have today. Throughout their studies, Parsons students benefit from over 1,200 accomplished artists and designers and faculty learning to weave together their different approaches and expertise to radically rethink design and create design solutions. We're part of a comprehensive university, as I mentioned. The broader university is the New School. The New School is actually younger than Parsons School Design. The New School was started in 1919 by professors from Columbia University that wanted to change creative thinking and ways of approaching education. The New School became a broader educational institution when Parsons joined the New School in 1970s. This became a comprehensive university with an art and design school housed within it, which made Parsons a unique art and design school, being part of a broader community of a broad university. So students interacted with students in social sciences and the liberal arts, really having a broader perspective and having opportunities to study other programs within the university. We have a strong international presence, which is reflective of New York City. About a third of our students are international, and we have the most small class sizes of any school in the United States. We have amazing facilities directly across the street in the Sheila Johnson Design Center. We have our brand new Making Center, which opened in the fall of 2013. We offer modeling and digital fabrication, 3D printing and CNCs, wood and metal fabrication, a print shop, ceramic studio, a photo cage, and a large and open kinetic classroom space. This is one of the open and kinetic classroom spaces that students get to create and make. So you'll have opportunity to work with students across our different divisions in university, and also really embrace the opportunity to take this space and make it your own and work. It's not a classroom space, but rather really a space for students to create and make and evolve their ideas and projects. We have exhibition spaces across the campus. This is a space directly across the street in the Sheila Johnson Design Center. We have over 4,000 square feet of exhibition space throughout our campus buildings. We have state-of-the-art facilities. You're currently sitting in our university center. This is only about 2 years old. Students interact here at the university center through our libraries, our cafeteria, various study spaces, and campus activities here in the university center. We are part of a consortium in our libraries, so students have libraries in all of our different academics buildings, which are located here in Lower Manhattan. In the consortium, Columbia University, Cooper Union, and NYU are all part of that, so you'll have access to those libraries as well. And we have over 600 workstations within our libraries. This is one of our many performance centers and stations throughout campus. The Tishman Auditorium is one of the largest in Lower Manhattan. We seat over 800 guests. So you'll have the opportunity to participate in public and private programming throughout your studies here. We also have a very strong, sustainable approach to the new school, our curriculum, and our campus as well. This is the largest LEED certified academic buildings in an academic urban center. So let's talk a little bit more about the AAS programs. As I mentioned, these programs are geared towards students who are looking for career transition or career enhancement. We have four different program areas: fashion design, fashion marketing, graphic design, and interior design. I'll go through each program a little bit. You'll also have the opportunity to hear from alumni from their experiences, but I'll talk a little bit about some of the alumni that have gone through our program previously. So in our fashion design program, you'll have the opportunity to learn through concept, through production. You're gonna learn techniques from sewing, drawing, draping, to more haute couture techniques. You'll have classroom critiques and lectures that bring professionals to our campus to provide their unique perspective to you as a student. We have partner institutions where you'll get to interact with, such as Coach, Louis Vuitton, Under Armour, and Swarovski, which provide valuable learning experiences from industry firms that help you develop your own creative ideas and practices. Erin Beatty is one of our recent alumni, or relatively recent alumni. In 2006, she was the creative director at SNU. She entered our fashion design program with a degree in English and Spanish. She started her professional career at Gap Inc. as a buyer and a product manager, but really wanted to move on into a more design focus, and she pursued the AAS degree in fashion design. After graduating, she started her own firm, SNU, and launched in 2009. It has a very strong sustainable focus. They create their products in Kenya, India, Italy, and New York and Peru. Prabal Garung is also one of our alumni. His glamorous style has been featured on such celebrities and famous people as former First Lady Michelle Obama and Demi Moore. In 2011, he was the winner of the CFDA Swarovski Award for Women's Wear and was a finalist for the National Design Award. He moved on to a career working with such firms as J. Crew, Target, and MAC Cosmetics. Ardistia Dwarsri is a 2004 graduate. She's the president and creative director of Ardistia New York. After receiving her bachelor's and master's degree in industrial and management engineering, Ardistia enrolled in the fashion design program to turn her lifelong interest in fashion into a career. At Parsons, she interned at Diane von Furstenberg. She later worked for Tommy Hilfiger, Gap, and Ann Taylor. And she ultimately launched her own brand, Ardistia New York, in 2007. Our fashion marketing program has a similar social and environmental component to it. The students in this program are more interested in the business and communication side of fashion. Students go on to work in merchandising, public relations, trend forecast, product development, and marketing related positions. You're gonna acquire the skills you need in color theory, fashion history, and master the business skills and consumer analysis, price structuring, and many other business skills. You'll also have the opportunity to work with top leading industry partners to help you gain your experience that you need to succeed in this field. These are some of the firms that our students have gone on to and some of the jobs that they've worked in. So merchandising analyst at Diesel, wholesale assistant at Eli Tahari, and associate planner at Theory, and those are just to name a few. Carrie Tham is a graduate of our fashion marketing program. She's a strategist now at Blues Womenwear. After getting a degree in commerce and working as an accountant before coming to Parsons, her background really helped her transition into a degree in fashion marketing, having experience in the analytics side of it. She collaborated with a BFA fashion design student when she was here and won a competition for Under Armour, and they entered into an intensive fashion design merchandise mentoring program at Under Armour. And an internship at Donna Karan helped her land a job as a merchandise planner at Donna Karan immediately after she graduated Parsons. She's now returned to her home country of Canada and is working for the Canadian luxury retail buyer or luxury retail company Blues Womenwear. Agesh Madan is the founder of, he's a 2011 alumni and the founder of Media Art Design House. He studied computer science while he was an undergraduate student. As experience at Stanford University's Global Entrepreneurial Strategies Program, including working at a fashion e-commerce firm, it rekindled his interest and experience in fashion marketing. He came to the fashion marketing program due to that experience and interest, and after graduating in 2011, he joined ISAIA, an Italian powerhouse known for its modern approach to tailoring and fabrics. He serves as the global director of product development, responsible for categories in sportswear and complete accessories. And in 2014, he launched his own company, Sophia. Our graphic design program, again, is for students looking for a career transition. They're looking to move on into the graphic design career. Students learn the relevant and basic skills that they'll need with solid foundations in graphic design and traditional practices to more advanced skills in typography, printmaking, page layout, publication design, and also investigate advanced and intermediate web design. Some of our students were recently named to the Type Directors Club for their work and were awarded certificates for typographical excellence to a dozen AAS students. And they have been able to deepen their professional and collaborative processes through this experience. Ed Nacional was a 2009 graphic design alumni. He was an illustrator and art director at his own firm, Ed Nacional Design. He worked at graphic design in the oil industry in Alberta, Canada, and applying his technical digital design skills while there. At Parsons, he's developed some conceptual foundations that have allowed him to flourish as a sought-after illustrator, identity designer, and art director. After a stint as an art directing editorial illustrations at the New York Times, Nacional went out on his own. His illustrations include publications like Time Magazine, The Washington Post, Newsweek, and The New Yorker. And he's now based in Brooklyn at his own firm, and he has clients such as MTV, Skillshare, J.Crew, to name a few. Janice U. Wexler is a 2006 alumni. She's the executive director of new media for MAC Cosmetics. After earning a BA in modern European history, Janice U. Wexler discovered an interest in graphic design while assisting as an art director at The New Yorker. This experience prompted Wexler to decide to get a formal education in graphic design. She began her design career as an art director at Zing Magazine and went on to serve as a senior direct designer at Visionaire and then worked as an art director at Teen Vogue. She currently serves as the art design director at Kate Spade and is currently the executive director of new media for MAC Cosmetics. Molly Crickman is a 2012 graphic design alumni. She's currently a freelance designer And during her undergraduate studies in English literature and creative writing, she explored graphic design while working on the university publications. After graduating in 2009, she decided to pursue her interest in graphic design through our AAS programs, an internship at the American Museum of Natural History on the Upper West Side, suggested by AAS faculty, led her to a full-time job even before she graduated. Her most recent job exhibitions are at Designer Christie's. Our interior design program dates back to the founding of our school. Frank Alva Parsons in 1906 started the first interior design program in the United States. The AAS program is organized around three design studies that focus on residential, retail, workplace, and hospitality spaces. Every interior design studio is multifaceted, combining interior architecture and decorative arts. Students learn the theory and practice of interior design through conceptual explorations of space, sustainability research, and study of computer-aided design techniques, and they discover the power of design to improve people's lives through solutions of global imperatives such as sustainability and economic inequality. Mary Davis is one of our alumni from 2009. She's currently the founder and principal designer of Mary Davis Interiors. Mary Davis received a bachelor's degree in comparative history and cultural anthropology before coming to our program. Davis cites opportunities she had at Parsons, such as mentoring some of our students in the drama program in 2010 that developed the skills in creating cost-effective and user-specific design. Today, Davis focuses on commercial interiors, partnerships with Home Polish, and an interior design startup. Edward Yadid lived in Paris before he came to New York. He decided to shift his studies from finance to a path that he thought was more creative for his interest. Architecture and interior design seemed like a perfect fit for him. There were areas that he was passionate about, and he can serve human needs at scales ranging from rooms to buildings. And when he came to New York in 2001, he found work with designer Noel Jeffrey. While taking interior design courses at Parsons, he eventually enrolled in the AAS programs. When friends requested design help, Yadid turned to an AAS professor, Thomas Hickey, and proposed that the two of them collaborate on a project. This success led Yadid to establish an interior design department within Hickey's firm, and today he works for the firm at Grade New York. And Carolyn Meersman is a 2007 design alumni, interior design alumni. She was born and raised in Italy. Carolyn studied philosophy before shifting her focus to Parsons, to interior design through our Parsons AAS programs. While at Parsons, she designed at intern firm Yabu Pusherberg, where she's designed hotels, retail spaces, residences. Some of the recent projects include the Hyatt New York, Clement Restaurant in the Peninsula in New York. She also is a current part-time faculty here, one of the many professionals that you might be able to study alongside. Many of our professionals in the program and faculty are also working professionals. We also offer you the opportunity to work with our academic support side and our career services side. So we're really there to help you through the entire arc of the program. We have an academic advising team that's there to help you select the correct courses to graduate on time, but also to maximize your learning outcomes and help you achieve the goal you want in your learning experience here. We also have a career services team that's here to help you with resume review, interview preparation, and help you get towards the career you want to. You'll actually hear from our Associate Director of Career Services in a little bit about some of the programs and offerings that they have, but we're really here to help you throughout the process from beginning to end through job placement. We also have campus life, so students that want to live here on campus, we have dorms, including in this building on the top floors. Students in the AAS programs do live here in the dorms. The majority do not, but we do offer that opportunity, and many of our students do live in our dorms, and many students are international, as I mentioned, so this does provide a great gateway, an opportunity to move to New York and limit some of the stress of moving to New York and really be acclimated to our community and our campus. We've had students work at a variety of different firms throughout New York City and the world. Some of the firms that our students have worked in the past were Yabu Pusherberg, Marc Jacobs, Pentagram, Coach, just to name a few. We also offer a variety of public programs. Last year, we had over 1,300 public programs. We have Oscar winners, Nobel laureates, fashion magnates that come here regularly. We're really fortunate to be in New York City. People come here, travel here, live here, and we invite people all the time to come. Last year, there's a few speakers such as Diane Van Furstenberg, Paula Scherer, Frank Gehry, and Victoria Beckham, just to name a few. So what do you have to do to come to the program? This is the kind of meat of what you want to know as far as applying. You get to hear a lot more in-depth information about the program specifics from our faculty and alumni after I speak. But this is a very straightforward application. There's a couple things you want to remember right away. Deadlines, our deadline, you still have plenty of time, is April 1st for fall 2017, and spring 2018 is October 15th. Every program will require an online application. It's specific to the AAS program. It's called the New School Application, and you'll want to complete the AAS application through the New School Application. All of the programs require creative assignments, and I'll talk about each creative assignment in a moment. You upload that as a PDF or Word document. You'll have to write a one-page statement of intent. We really want you to focus on what you're interested in coming to the program for. What have you been doing recently? Have you recently graduated from college, or have you been working as an accountant for 7 years and you want to go into fashion design and this program is right for you? We really want you to focus on that, the recent now and why Parsons and why that program. And then we want to see a relevant resume or CV. If you're looking for career transition, it's likely that you don't have any experience in fashion design. We don't care. What we really want to know is what you've been doing recently. So you've been a senior accountant moving up in your firm or whatever. We want to see what you've been doing for the last several years professionally. If you're a recent college graduate, include internships and that sort to see what you've been doing in college. For the creative assignment, each program has its different creative assignment. For our graphic design program, you're going to create a stamp with a fruit or vegetable within the stamp. For our fashion marketing program, you're going to write a 500-word essay critiquing what you see as a successful fashion marketing campaign. Really pay attention to critical thinking skills. That's what we're looking to see within your essay. And of course, have someone read it over for grammar and content. For our fashion design program, we want you to design the ideal or man you'd like to design for through a creative collage assignment. And then focus on textures, colors, patterns, how you see that you would execute that. And then our interior design program, you're going to design an interior design space with in mind that it's an advertising agency with an urban townhouse. We want to see what the rooms look like, what types of furniture you're using, color patterns, lighting, how you feel you would execute that space. Again, many of you are looking for career transition, so we're really looking for your vision, and we're going to help mold those skills when you come here, but put your best time and effort into creating what you see your future will hold in those creative assignments and your vision for those. All students have to submit official college transcripts or transcripts when they apply. As I mentioned, the majority of students do come with professional academic background. If you have more than 24 college credits, which is the majority of our students, we do require only college transcripts. If you do not have at least 24 college credits, we do also require high school transcripts. Many of our students are international, as I said, about a third of our students. If you attained a degree, even if you're a domestic student outside the United States, you'll need a WES or NASIS member organization course-by-course evaluation. This can be time-consuming, so I encourage you to start this process as soon as possible. Go to WES.org or NASIS.org and start the process, because it can take several weeks to a month to complete. And many of our students are international, so just start investigating that process as soon as possible. For those of you that attained a degree in the United States, just contact your previous university and have them sent to the new school directly. If English is not your native language, we'll need a TOEFL, IELTS, or PTE English score when you apply. And if you've attained a degree in the United States or at a school that was taught primarily in English, this can be waived for non-native English speakers. Many of our students are international and have got a degree at a school that was taught in English. This can be waived, and you indicate that in the application. Otherwise, we would need that English language score. As I mentioned just a minute ago, most of our students have prior academic experience, and so many will come into the program with transfer credits, which ultimately shortens the length of your time here and will save you money in the long run, because you'll finish the program sooner. If you are a native English speaker and you have a bachelor's degree at a school that was taught in English, you'll automatically get 21 credits. If you are a student who attained a degree at a school that was not taught in English, or English is not your native language, and you received a degree that was taught in English, you'd automatically get 15 credits for liberal arts credits. In addition to that, you can get 10 more studio credits. So all of the programs are eligible for studio credits: interior design, graphic design, fashion marketing, and fashion design. Those are painting, ceramics, drawing, sewing, graphic design, any of those types of courses. They would have to be for credit, and you'd have to receive a C or higher from a regionally accredited university. Again, we would need your official transcripts, and after you apply, and if you're admitted, we'll review that, and we'll give you a transfer credit evaluation to determine which ones are available. Specifically to fashion design and fashion marketing, you could get business credits in lieu of studio credits, or a combination of studio and business, but no more than 10 in total for the studio or business for our fashion design and fashion marketing programs, and it's only those two programs that can get business credits instead of studio credits, or a combination of the two. So after you apply, you can check the status of your application online through the Admissions Hub. A few days after you apply, you'll receive an email with your login information to check your Admissions Hub. This is the location where you can follow up on the status of your application, see what we've received. Have we received your test scores? Have we received your transcripts? Have we received your WES evaluation? It takes approximately 2 weeks after you apply before this is updated to allow us time to process all of those documents with your application. After that point, we encourage you to contact us if you see something that's missing. It does take several days to process materials after we receive it, so we ask you to allow a little patience when we receive materials, but it will be updated continuously, and you'll be able to check after 2 weeks to see the status of your application. This is also where the decision will be made. Once a decision is made, you'll receive an email notification that you can retrieve that decision through your admissions hub. I encourage you to continually throughout the season check your admissions hub to see your status. Currently, our tuition is $45,080 per year. That's both fall and spring semester. So it's half of that per semester. We also offer part-time and full-time enrollment for these programs. And through the part-time enrollment, it would be 1530 per credit. Please note that if you're an international student, you'd have to be enrolled full-time to attain a student visa if you do require a student visa. Many of our students are local as well, living here in New York and taking classes after work. And so we do offer part-time. And then international aid and domestic aid, approximately 60% of all of our students receive merit-based or need-based aid, or a combination of the two. So most of our students do receive aid. If you're a domestic student that's eligible for FAFSA, or a non-citizen that's eligible for FAFSA, please complete it. Our school code is 002780. The priority deadline is as soon as possible, so please complete that as soon as possible. We offer a student financial services team that's there to support you through that process if you have questions about completing it, or after you complete it, you have questions about the aid that you've been offered. They're there to support you throughout the process. All students, like I said, are considered for merit-based aid. All you need to do is apply. Based on the quality of that overall application, you'd be considered eligible for merit-based aid. We look at your resume, your creative assignment, your state of intent, your previous academic experience. If you've had professional experience, we look at that as well, and we weigh those all into it. International and domestic students are considered for it. International students are also considered for need-based aid. You'll complete a separate need-based aid application. It's the AAS need-based aid application. You'll have to submit a variety of bank documents, and our international student financial services team can also help you with that process, but complete that right away after you apply as well as an international student to be considered for need-based aid. So that really brings me to my conclusion of my presentation. We're always here to help answer any questions you want about the program itself or about the application process. Our email is thinkparsons@newschool.edu. There is one thing I forgot to mention, I just want to mention. Our fashion marketing program is the only program that's offered both online and on campus. So we have students attending this program all over the world and taking them remotely, or even living in the United States, taking it remotely. So if you're interested in fashion marketing, you can take that online, but you must have received a bachelor's degree to attain the degree fashion marketing online only. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy the upcoming sessions. It's a really amazing experience to hear from the faculty. These are really unique opportunities. The faculty are very busy, as you can imagine, and it's a really amazing opportunity to interact with them, ask them questions. You're here today for a reason. Really ask engaging questions. That's what they're here for. Ask the alumni engaging questions. That's what they're here for. And I'd now like to introduce our Associate Director of Career Services, Marissa LoBianco, who will talk a little bit about career services opportunities and introduce some of the faculty that will speak here this morning. Thank you.
I think I have some slides up here, so I will pop those in. I might just go without them, actually. Good morning, everyone. Nice to see you here. I'm Marissa LoBianco from Career Services, and I wanted to talk to you about the many ways that we support students who come to these programs in making sure that they're getting internships, that they're getting jobs upon graduation. So when students start here, they are assigned a success advisor, and that is basically a holistic advisor who is working not just with careers, but also with your academics, so that they're really looking at the bigger picture and understanding how your courses match up with your potential career path. And that person is there to have one-on-one conversations with you, to review your resume, discuss cover letter, job search tactics and techniques, as well as, you know, using social media or practicing for interviews. And our success advisors know and understand that a lot of you may be going through a career transition and understand how to look at your documents so that we are helping you rebrand yourself for this new career, because that is quite a unique thing to do, and we want to make sure that you feel confident and know that there is a way to both use your transferable skills from a prior career to support your career advancement, but then also make that segue into the new field by pursuing internships and getting those other opportunities. The department itself is Career Services and Experiential Opportunities, and that experiential piece of it, by and large, includes internships. And a lot of our students do internships. Generally, we may not recommend for the first semester, just so that you have time to acclimate and meet with your advisor and make sure that your materials are really of high quality before you're putting those applications in. But our students do multiple internships, and they are interning at a variety of places, as well as getting hired at a variety of places. And I know that Phil did a great job of mentioning some of those companies. And really, our students intern and work almost everywhere. You really have the ability to shape your path. If there's some place that you want to work or intern, even if no one here has done that before, it's absolutely open to you, and we will encourage and support you through that process. So we do support you in paving your own way in that. But all of the largest companies, if I had to think of a few that were recently here, Nike, International Furniture Design Association, Intuit, Yabu Puschelberg, but they really sort of span, and our alumni wind up interning and working all throughout the country and really all throughout the world. So the opportunities are out there, and we're going to make sure that they're available to you. So once you've been prepared with your success advisor, we encourage you to apply, and we do have our online job board called The Village, and that's where employers who specifically are seeking Parsons students are posting jobs. So you're open to access jobs there, but of course you can go anywhere else. We also are running a lot of events on campus, so we have your traditional career fairs every semester, and they're pretty much cohort specific, so we'll have a fashion fair, we'll have a more general design type of fair, we'll be having other ones for the students in interior design, so we do gear those so that you feel that the employers there are really looking for you and your skills and talents. And as someone who speaks to employers all of the time, what I can say is Parsons is a great place to be, because just having it on your resume, these employers are really looking for you, and that name bears, you know, a very high quality stamp. So it's a great place to graduate from, and I love hearing, that's one of the favorite parts of my job, that these students are really wanted, so they know that they've come to the right place. Other types of events besides employer events, we have the career fairs. Employers come and do individual info sessions. Sometimes they'll just table, you know, in one of our lobbies and engage in students in a very informal way. But we also do workshops and helping you refine those skills so that you are branding yourself, whether that's using social media, whether it's how to create a portfolio, or also to support our international students. We do intro to US work culture workshops. And then we're also doing employer panels, so we'll do themed nights. We call them Meet the Industry Experts, and we'll invite a handful of panelists from different industries to talk on those topics. because really that's one of the best ways to, you know, learn and understand how can I get to where I want to go, because we know that that end goal might not always be so clear at the beginning, and that's okay. Career development is not a linear process, and it might take you a couple of different places, and that's actually a really positive thing, because that's what builds your experience and what creates you as a person, and when you're going onto the market, really shows your the depth and the breadth of your skills. We're also keeping in touch with communication. We're emailing when there are really great jobs. We're emailing with those paid internship opportunities, because we want to make sure that you know wherever it is you want to go, we want to be there alongside with you. And not only that, even once you graduate, we have an alumni career advisor who works with you. So even once you've gone out there, 5 years in, you're looking for a new job, however many years afterwards that that might be, there's still an advisor who's there to sit down and help you craft that new resume, remarket yourself, and position yourself in a way that will get you the job that you want. So those are the multiple ways that we support you. And again, there's no one way, so really the best way to learn about career paths is by hearing from alumni who have graduated from the programs. So I'd like to take a few minutes now to invite some alumni to join us on a panel and speak to you a little bit about their experiences, which I think you could really learn a lot from. So we have Claire Torok from Interior Design. I'm going to invite you each to grab a seat. Okay. And Claire graduated in 2011 and is currently working in hospitality, and she will share a little bit more with you. Carmen McLeod. Carmen is a 2014 graduate of our graphic design program, and she's actually currently working here in our marketing and communications department for the new school. Monica Singh. Monica is a graduate of our fashion marketing program in 2012 and currently a designer and branding expert. And lastly, Nikita Varma. Nikita is a graduate of our fashion design program from 2008, and she has developed her own label focusing on sustainable practices. So I'll now give each of them a few minutes to talk about, you know, what brought them here, their experience, and how they wound up where they are. So we'll start off with Claire.
Sure. So I came to Parsons for the pretty straightforward reason of wanting to get into interior design. I had studied undergrad urban planning and art, and after school worked at a museum for 2 years, where I kind of firsthand saw exhibition design, and the light bulb went off that this really married my two loves of design and art. So I researched programs and found Parsons, and was really attracted to it initially because of how quickly it would get me into the working world. But then when I got here, I was surprised by how great the studio classes were and what a dynamic community it was, so yeah.
Okay, thank you. And now Carmen will tell us a little bit.
Sure, so I also studied art. I got a BFA and an MFA in painting, and I spent a couple years pursuing that career here in New York, and it was going fine, but I felt like at a certain point, after I had my daughter actually, that I wanted something a little bit more with a steady career trajectory. And I enrolled at Parsons actually without doing a whole lot of research first, so I'm very impressed that you're all here doing this. And discovered that what I thought was going to be essentially learning how to design websites was a whole practice in and of itself that ended up replacing my career as an artist in a really happy way. It's a whole entire career and practice that has opened up for me as a designer. So it was an unexpected discovery, really.
And thank you very much. Moving on to Monica.
Hi, I'm Monica Singh. I'm from AAS Fashion Marketing, graduate from 2016. I came to Parsons because it was my dream school, and I graduated in 2009 with a fashion design degree from India. and I won International Fashion Forecasting Diploma from Domus Academy, Italy as well. And I just came with an idea that not just to be a creative person, I should be an entrepreneur, and I wanted to learn how to process my design skill into a proper business or idea which can really reach to the market. So that's why I chose fashion marketing, because I think this course has one of those platforms which opens many doors. And you can always pick any doors, and I chose branding along with my designing. So this was interesting, transformational idea and experience for my life, because I came all over from the different countries. So being in being at the Parsons is like opening different chapter and meeting students and friends from different country. So fashion marketing is not just a course for just to study what we think is marketing is all about, but fashion marketing is an education which tells you what else you can do without having fear.
Thanks, Monica. And Nikita?
Hi, so I did fashion design. Before I came to Parsons, I had did my undergrad in economics. And I also did my MBA, and I was working in India, so I came from India as well. So I was working in banking before I came here, and I always had a dream of becoming a designer. I used to do that as a hobby. I would just, you know, make sketches and take it to the tailors or seamstresses and be like, just, can you make this for me? But I never had the technical knowledge. I would just have to say whatever they said, okay, no, this can't be done or whatever. So I would have to be like, okay, fine. But at one point I decided I want to make this my career. So I came to Parsons. And Parsons really helped. I came here with no technical knowledge. Just, it sounds very cliched, but I came here with a dream. And no technical knowledge. So Parsons really helped me gain that, and that too really fast. The learning curve, I would say there was no curve, it was just like a big slant. I learned things really fast, all the technical, my teachers were really awesome, like sewing, draping, all this technical stuff that you need to know even if you want to become an entrepreneur and not a designer. A lot of people just want to become a fashion entrepreneur but not a designer. As such, even for that, you need to know the technical knowledge. So yeah, Parsons helped me a lot to gain that skill. That helped me after I graduated. I worked, I interned a lot. Also because my teachers used to say that Parsons is your school, but New York City also is your school. Like you need to really go out there and intern and learn from other designers, and I took that to heart, and I interned a lot. Interned with Marc Jacobs and Luca and DBF, to name a few. Then after that, I worked full time, and then I started my own line. So definitely, I would say that I made a really good choice by coming here.
Great, thank you. So I'd also like to follow up with just one more question. I think it'd be great to hear a little bit more about what it is that you're all doing now and how you feel the program here helped you succeed in that career.
So I work at a design firm now called Averico. It's a hospitality design firm. We design restaurants, bars, hotels in New York. Immediately, or during Parsons actually, I interned for a residential designer who actually found on the career net. And that led to my first job, which then opened up a network of people, and things just kind of spiraled from there. I worked for another hospitality design firm after school before ending up at Averco 4 years ago.
Let's see, so when I graduated, which doesn't seem like that long ago, it was a little over 2 years ago, I took an unpaid internship that I had found through an internship fair here. And it was really intentional for me to kind of ease into working life because I had actually decided, even though I was enrolled on a part-time basis, four classes still qualifies as part-time, but I can tell you it took up all of my time. So I hadn't been working for the couple of semesters that I had been doing the graphic design program. And I took the unpaid internship to sort of get a lay of the land. It seemed like I wanted to see what working in a small agency would be like. And I was working in a sort of a branding and advertising agency, really, really small on the Lower East Side, called All Day, Every Day. And it was really cool, interesting work. But it seemed like a lot of the people that were doing really well there were working really long hours, and I wasn't sure that it was really the culture that I wanted to be, the office culture that I wanted to be in. And then one of my former professors, Kasia Gruda, I'd been in contact with her, and I'd worked with her a little bit, doing some student work and helping. Let's see, I had designed her the reinstatement package that all professors have to do. Anyway, I'd done some work with her, and she introduced me to Ed Puz, who is the art director in the marketing and communications department here at the New School. And after a conversation with him, I knew it was the perfect opportunity. I wanted to work with him. He used to be the art director at the MoMA, and just the conversation that we had about design and how it can function in the world as a personal sort of practice as a designer really spoke to me. And my first project was actually designing the viewbook that a lot of you have in your hand right now for the AAS program. And so I was doing that as a freelancer, and then maybe 5 months into that, I was encouraged to apply for a staff position at the New School. So I'm now the lead communication designer in the marketing and communication department. And it is, it's a really wonderful work culture. It's a shifting space. There's new organizational ideas about how we're running it. It's become less of a design studio and more of a marketing environment, which has not been what I expected, but is interesting. And I feel like I'm just now starting to get a sense of what area of graphic design really speaks to me, and I'm able to pursue that actually in this environment, which is great.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what to say. Kind of so right now, currently I'm working as a branding expert and designer in a small firm in the fashion district here. And we work, I design the brand, whatever they want to launch, because I have previous experience into e-commerce, how to start a business, and how to design a line from collection, from idea till the merchandising and the production. So I handle their menswear and womenswear. And when I came to New York, I came with an experience of 7 years in my hand. I work as a senior buyer, designers, and merchandiser in e-commerce company in India back then. And then I had a dual degree before, and then this was something when I came, it was like whole beginning of, you know, the starting a new career. Being an international student, it was like interesting to get into the, the international market to work as a professional and proving themselves. So I've done a couple of internship in a buying house here, and I've been offered a lot of internship with the big designers, but the internship was something that I couldn't do. And I think because of the Parsons, the portfolio which I created myself, besides being into marketing, my portfolios included my design and my marketing skills and everything. I had an opportunity to work at the Chanel. I had an opportunity to work with Oscar De La Renta as well, but then something led to another. I couldn't do those things. The point is, when I done fashion marketing, I graduated from here, I literally felt that I can do a lot more what I have learned here, because I'm combining my education and my experience along with my Parsons degree too. So I did internship because it was part of the program and we had to do it, but then I started my own firm where I teach underprivileged girls about the fashion design and communication and a little bit of marketing skill. So I do that as well, besides my day job. And I work on small project, which has a social advocacy programs where I'm currently working with one of the new school alumni from 2005. And so the project is all about including fashion and philanthropy together. So my point is, why I'm saying this, that I know that Parsons is a fashion school, and then we learn here, which is what we have heard the bigger designers' name and everything, they are there, but they also open so many doors, so many reasons for you to follow your any other path. So fashion marketing especially is a course which I love the most about is they make you entrepreneur. You find out and you learn so much about the fashion industry and the behind the scene, how to start something. If you are a designer right now, you should know how to start your own business. You should know how to market yourself. You should know whatever the knowledge you are getting at. And the students who, fellow students you are studying here in a fashion marketing course especially, they have a background from the different school from the new school itself. So it's amazing that same creative ideas came from a different direction, different country, different perspective can bring a lot of changes. So right now I'm working with a lot of people and some of the alumni from new school and some of the artists outside to combine my whole both passion, fashion and entrepreneurship along with the philanthropy. So I think that's what I'm doing right now. There's so much to do again. Thanks.
So after I graduated, I worked here full-time for a company as an assistant technical designer. And that was also a very good experience because going from school to the real fashion world is very different. It's a different experience, and I learned a lot, but then I wanted to start my own line. So I did that. I went back to India and I started my clothing line there. I participated in the Indian Fashion Week and I was selling in some of the high-end multi-designer stores in India. But obviously, once you come to New York calls you back, I guess. So I came back here and then I was working on my label part-time here and I was also freelancing for other companies as a designer. And I got some really good opportunities. Here I became, I got an opportunity to become a wardrobe, official wardrobe sponsor for Miss America. And I was also a clothing sponsor for Miss United States and Miss New York. And I did a couple of shows in New York as well. Did a charity show with a lot of different title holders, US title holders. So I was really exposed to very good opportunities, and I think the name of Parsons has got something to do with it, I'm sure. Right now what I'm doing is I'm trying to transition a little bit, trying to branch my brand into more a sustainable fashion label, because I've learned a lot, I've been reading up a lot, and I feel sustainability is something that is really important for the fashion industry to imbibe because of all the different issues, global warming, whatever is going on. So that's what I'm working on. I'm working on creating a sustainable label which also uses artisan skills and gives back to artisan communities around the world. So that's what I'm working on right now.
Okay.
Well, thank you so much for sharing. I think it's incredibly helpful, especially to hear how you utilize school services and also those connections. We'll always say that networking is really key. It's really helpful to know people. You know, you'll have your education, but that certainly helps you guide you along the way. And I think there will be these alumni and some more available to speak to you during the breakout sessions. So I'll lead you into the next part of your program. Thanks.
You guys.
Thank you.
Thank you for your time. So last but not least, I'd like to introduce our Executive Director of Parsons School Design, Joel Towers, who would like to thank you for joining us today and say a few words.
Thanks, Phil. In a few minutes, you'll get to stretch your legs and head out to some of the breakout sessions, hear quite a bit more about the program, speak with faculty, which I think will be a very valuable experience for you. I just wanted to say a couple of words of welcome, first of all. As Dean of Parsons, I've been here now for 13 years and 8 years in this role as Dean, and I can tell you that the period of time at which you will be entering, or I hope you will be entering Parsons, is truly extraordinary. We've done some very, very important work over the course of the last decade to rethink and reposition all of our academic programs across Parsons. And in fact, it's a very rich and vibrant ecosystem that you'll be entering into as a student here. It's a mixture, of course, of undergraduate bachelor's programs and graduate master's programs, but the associate's programs play a very particular role in that ecosystem because it brings to the school a collection of students, who many of whom have tremendous experience already under their belts, come here because they feel that there's an opportunity to transition or advance into a new career or advance in an existing career. And it's a very compelling proposition, a really interesting group of students, because you bring a maturity to your studies that allow you to really focus and take advantage of the resources that are here. And I strongly encourage you to do so should you choose to come to Parsons, because it's, as I said, it's this very rich and dynamic ecosystem, and you have opportunity and access to all of these different types of learners and to this diverse university community across the range of the social sciences and performance and policy, and of course this very rich art and design and business culture that is Parsons. I just last night had the very interesting and coincidental opportunity to speaking with Paul Van Sile, who's the co-founder of Mayette, which many of you probably are aware of if you're in the areas of fashion or business. But Paul is very much like you, someone who has transitioned throughout his career, in his case from the law and working in Truth and Reconciliation Commission in South Africa through a range of different activities that bring him then to enter into fashion and fashion business in the last 6 or 7 years with the founding of Mayette and the extraordinary success that that company has had, opening up a niche in a marketplace that is very much driven by social justice, by concerns around environment, and by using fashion in this case and design to really advance those issues. And so in fact, it's a very close analogy to the kind of experience that I think many of our students seek to undertake. So it's an extraordinary time to be here. The world of art and design has changed dramatically in the last decade, and it certainly will in the course of the next. There's never been, I think, a more important time to be doing this work, because the kinds of opportunities that arise from the particular challenges facing the world today demand that there are creative and entrepreneurial and engaged individuals undertaking these challenges and turning them into opportunities. Design has actually never been more valuable and important than it is today. So I strongly encourage you to pursue that, whether you do so with us, which I hope you will, or somewhere else. Lastly, one of the things you learn as dean is to never contradict your alumni, but I will slightly. Or I will add to something that Monica said moments ago when she described Parsons as a fashion school. It is, of course, a school with a deep and rich tradition in fashion. Many, many of the most successful alumni, both in fashion design and fashion business, have come out of this school, and we are deeply proud of that. But it is also a school with a long and rich tradition in every area of design, across the graphic and fine arts, as well as in interior design. In fact, the year that we launched fashion design is the same year that we launched interior design in 1906, and have been the longest running programs in those areas in this country. So you come to a place, so that's just a friendly amendment to what Monica said. You come to us, I think, and you've heard quite a bit about our name, our reputation, our history, and it's true. We take it very, very seriously. It's an incredible honor and a privilege for those of us who work here as faculty, which is how I first came to Parsons, and in the administration, to safeguard that legacy and to transition it to the future, which is why we do the curricular work we do, which is why it's so important to welcome people like yourselves into our cohort of students and ultimately to our long and large list of alumni. So I hope you will come to Parsons. I hope that this next hour will provide you an opportunity to learn more about the programs, and welcome, and thank you for being here today. Phil?